Do you know how many people use Microsoft Excel across the world? I thought it is very interesting to find the answer. Let me know what you think in the comment section and stay tuned for the answer at the end of this video. Microsoft lately announced so many new functions for its Office 365 users. One of the newly introduced functions is Let function. It is super simple and it has a lot of use cases. It is not just easy, it also improves a lot of readability of your Excel formulas. By the end of this video, you will learn three ways you must know how to use let function. So without further ado, let's get started. What is let function? Let function allows you to create variables for your values. If you don't know what is variable, don't worry, we'll go through that. But let's look at the syntax of this function. If you look here, we have mainly key value pairs in this function and then calculation. When I say key value pair, basically you have a variable, you can give any name to that variable and value that variable holds. And once you specify any number of key value pairs, the last argument would be the calculation. If you look at the simple example here, we have variable name as x and the value is 10. That means x holds value of 10, and the next argument is y, whose value is 5. That means y holds value of 5, and the last argument is x plus y. What that does is it basically adds x and y. Here x holds 10 and y holds 5, so it adds 10 plus 5 and returns 15. Let's look at a simple example of let function in action. For this video, let's use student exam points data. As you see here, we have student name and points in biology exam as well as English exam. Now we want to use let function to add these two points together for each student. So click on the cell, type equal to let parenthesis. Now name one means here we need to create variable name, so I say this as biology points. What the value should go to this variable? So I click the cell. The next one, I'll use English points as variable's name. Then what the value should go to here is this cell. And now we have two key value pairs. Now fifth argument should be the calculation. So I simply use biology points. See, as you type bio, it suggests name. So I simply hit tab plus English tab and close parenthesis. Hit enter. Now it calculated total of 2 points. This can be done using simple sum function. But the difference here is it is more readable. In let function, you can simply say that you are adding biology points with English points. Whereas in sum function, you don't know what is B4 and C4 in this context. You have to go manually to those cells and see what those are. Let's look at a scenario where we can use this let function, or usage of let function makes more sense. As we see here, we have students' data. Let's assume that we have this challenge. We need to find list of students who passed, that means whose marks is more than 60 combining biology and English. And if he is not passed, and we need to find how many more marks the student needs to get passed. We can do that by a let function. So click on this one, let. I can add both marks, like say total marks comma, the value is nothing but adding these two cells comma. Now we can use if total marks tab greater than 60, then I use pass. If not, then I want to see how many marks he needed. So I'll simply do 60 minus total marks. So I close if parenthesis and then I close let parenthesis, hit enter. So we can do this same thing by simple if statement. As you see here, if you compare these two functions, of course if function is more simpler than let function, but let function gives you more readability. And main important thing is that we are not doing calculation multiple times. If you look at if, we are adding these two cells one time and two, total two times, whereas in let function we are performing this addition only once. So it increases processing speed. Of course in this case it is just a simple calculation, it may not show much impact on performance, but let's assume if you have thousands of rows, then that's where you start seeing the difference. We always knew that functions always take a single value as an input and it gives one value as an output. As you see here from previous example, it is taking two cells and adding together. But what's something new with these dynamic array functions in Office 365 is we can pass arrays as input and we can get arrays as output. Let function is also one of the dynamic array functions. Here we can still pass arrays as input. Let's see how it can be done here. So let's go back to the function here. Here we have biology points and we selected cell B4. Instead, what we can select here is we can select all the values as list of array. Similarly, instead of selecting only single cell of C4, we can select all the values and as array. So if you see here, we are passing two input arguments, B4 to B18 and C4 to C18, and the calculation is same as previous one, just adding those two together and hit enter. As soon as you hit enter, it spill the results in adjacent cells. That means it did additions for each of these two cells and put the value in this output cell. Even though we did not create formula for each of these cells, but only one formula that puts the results in all the adjacent cells. This is what something we call spill. You should get familiar with this spill term. It will be used in many functions coming in Office 365 dynamic arrays series. One more use case of let function is debugging. It is very useful when we have complex formulas which has a lot of functions in it. For example, let's take a look at a formula which we have discussed in the previous example. As you see here, this is the formula from previous example. I can alter this function a little bit to make it easy for us to debug. So here I say, let's say results and output as result. Function output is same, doesn't change, but now instead of having the calculation field at the very end, now we create it as a variable. So with this, for example, if you want to know the value of total marks, you can simply type total marks here and you can see the value. So when you do this, you don't have to delete the final calculation. This way it is very helpful for debugging purpose. As I promised, these three are must know use cases of let function. Going back to the question I asked at the beginning of this video, how many people uses Excel across the world? That answer is 1.5 billion people. It's almost 20% of world population. Isn't it insane? I really find it is very interesting and how valuable Excel is in our lives. If you like this video, please hit that thumb icon. And also don't forget to subscribe you want to get notified when new content gets published. Thank you for watching.